spinach. Babies. You're better off raising tomatoes.
By the time she was two, Matilda had learned what most people learn in their early 30s, how to take care of herself.
As time went by, she developed a sense of style. Every morning, Matilda's older brother, Michael, went to school.
Come on, get out of here.
Her father went to work selling used cars for unfair prices. And her mother took off to play bingo.
Soup's on the stove. Heat it up if you get hungry.
Matilda was left alone. That was how she liked it.
Well, pick me up with golden hand.
Any packages come today? Where'd all this come from?
A library.
The library? You've never set foot in a library. You're only 4 years old.
Six and a half.
You're four.
Six and a half.
If you were six and a half, you'd be in school already.
I want to be in school. I told you I was supposed to start school in September. You wouldn't listen.
Get up. Get up. Get out here. Give me that book. Here is pie. How old is Matilda?
Four. I'm six and a half, Mommy.
Five, then.
I was six in August.
You're a liar.
I want to go to school.
School? It's out of the question. Who would be here to sign for the packages? We can't leave valuable packages sitting out on the doorstep. Now go watch TV like a good kid.
You know, sometimes I think there's something wrong with that girl.
Tell me about it.
Hey, dip face! Have a marshmallow! Have another marshmallow, dip face! Dip face!
Sometimes Matilda longed for a friend, someone like the kind, courageous people in her books. It occurred to her that, like talking dragons and princesses with hair long enough to climb, such people might exist only in storybooks. But Matilda was about to discover that she could be her own friend, that she had a kind of strength she wasn't even aware of.
I'm great. I'm incredible. Michael, pencil and paper in the kitchen.
Oh. Did we sell some cars today, honeydew?
Did we?
Does that mean I can get that new TV?
Yeah. Son, one day you're going to have to earn your own living. It's time you learn the family business. Sit down. Write this down. All right. The first car your brilliant father sold cost $320. I sold it for $1,158. The second one cost $512. Mm-hmm. I sold it for $2,269.
Wait, Dad, you're going too fast.
Just right. The third cost $68. I sold it for $999. And the fourth cost $1,100. I sold it for $7,839 big American boffos.
Harry!
What was my profit for the day?
Can you repeat the last one?
$10,265. Check it if you don't believe me.
You're a little cheat. You saw the paper.
From all the way over here?
Are you being smart with me? If you're being smart with me, young lady, you're going to be punished.
Punished for being smart?
For being a smart aleck. When a person is bad, that person has to be taught a lesson.
Person?
Get up. Get up. Get
Harry up. Wormwood had unintentionally given... She pictured a lovely building surrounded by trees and flowers and swings. Well, there was a building. And children.
So regardless of what Crunchham Hall looked like, she was happy to be there.
Hey, wait up!
After all, any school is better than no school at all, isn't it?
You're too small. Grow up quicker. Heads up, shoulders back, stomachs in. Stand up straight.
Hey, sorry.
Attention for you.
That's okay. It's much better than being out there. Is that my teacher? No, that's the principal, Miss Trunchbull.
You've got to be kidding.
You squirts better skedaddle. I'm not kidding. The Trunchbull likes to snap a whip in there to see who's trying to hide.
Stop again! Change those socks to pink.
I'm Matilda.
Lavender.
I'm Hortensia.
Hi. She doesn't really hit children with that riding crop, does she?
No, it's mostly for scare. What she does is worse. Like yesterday, in the second grade, the Trunchbull makes a weekly visit to every classroom to show the teachers a thing or two about handling kids. And Julius Rotwinkle ate 2 M&Ms during her lesson.
And she caught him?
Of course.
Was Julius okay?
After being thrown out the window? Of course he wasn't okay. He lived, if that's what you mean.
The Trunchbull used to be in the Olympics. Shot put, javelin, hammer throw.
The hammer throw's her specialty.
So she does this all the time?
Better than being put in the chokey.
Chokey?
Yeah, the chokey. It's a tall, narrow hole in a wall behind a door. You have to stand in a drippy pipe with jagged edges, and the walls have broken glass and nails sticking
get
out.
Get inside, you festering ball of pus!
She puts kids in there?
I've been in twice. Sometimes she leaves you in there all day.
But didn't you tell your parents?
They didn't believe me. I mean, would your parents believe it?
60 lines after school. I must obey Miss Trunchbull.
No.
Out of my way.
Here she comes.
Ah, fresh meat. Amanda Thripp.
Yes, Miss Trunchbull.
What are those?
What's what, Miss Trunchbull?
Hanging down by your ears.
You mean my pigtails?
Are you a pig, Amanda?
No, Miss Trunchbull.
Do I allow pigs in my school?
My mommy thinks they're sweet.
Your mommy is a twit. You'll chop those off before school tomorrow, or I will come around. But!
I don't.
Did you say but? Hammer throw. I'll give you butt!
Good loss!
Excellent release! Think she'll make the fence?
Can we close one?
Before I throw you all in a
chokey. Traitorous.
Some are brightly colored and secrete irritating substances.
Don't you keep going, you useless flaming car! Wormwood, sell me a lemon. You're heading for the chokey, young lady.
Chokey?
Teach you a lesson.
What lesson?
You and your father think you can make a fool out of me.
My father?
The guy with a stupid haircut.
I'm looking like
my thought.
You're the spitting image. The apple never rots far from the tree.
Miss Honey!
Miss Trunchbull teaches our class 3 lavender. Please get a water pitcher.
But Miss Honey!
She'll be here any second. Come on. Oh, make sure the water's cold, Lavender. Finny, cover the fish. Put away the art projects. Put away anything colorful. Oh, Charlie, won't you get those crayons for me?
Most great ideas come from hard work and careful planning. Of course, once in a while, they just jump out at you.
Reyna, cover the birds and the beetles. Hurry.
I hear her coming.
Okay, now, last time, some of you forgot yourselves. Don't speak unless you're spoken to. Don't laugh, don't smile, don't even breathe loudly.
Don't breathe at all.
Morning, Miss Trunchbull.
Morning, Miss Trunchbull.
Sit! Shoo.
I have never been able to understand why small children are so disgusting. They're the bane of my life. They're like insects. They should be got rid of as early as possible. My idea of a perfect school is one in which there are no children at all. Do you agree, Miss Honey? Now, you, front of the class. I tell you to empty your pockets, you'll do it faster, won't you?
Excuse me, Miss Trunchbull.
Miss Honey, this could be the most interesting thing you've ever done. Sit down, you squirming worm of vomit.
Thank you, Miss Trunchbull.
Can you spell?
Miss Honey taught us how to spell a long word yesterday. We can spell difficulty.
You couldn't spell difficulty if your life depended on it.
She taught us with a poem.
A poem? How sweet. What poem would that be?
Mrs. D, Mrs. I.
Mrs. F, F, I. Mrs. C, Mrs. U, Mrs. L, T, Y.
Why are all these women married? Mrs. D, Mrs. I, you're supposed to be teaching spelling, not poetry. Can't for the life of me understand why small children take so long to grow up. I think they do it deliberately, just to annoy me. I believe that you should believe in whatever power you think you have inside of you. Believe it with all your heart. That's where Miss Trunchbull lives.
Why is there a swing?
A girl I know used to live in that house. Her life was good and happy. When she was just 2 years old, her mother died. Her father was a doctor. And he needed someone to look after things at home, so he invited the mother's stepsister to come and live with him. But the girl's aunt was a mean person who treated the girl very badly.
The Trunchbull?
Yes. And worst of all, when the girl was 5, her father died.
How did her father die?
The police decided he'd killed himself.
Why would he do such a thing?
No one knows. The end is happier. She found a small cottage. She rented it from this lovely rhubarb farmer for just $50 a month. And she covered it in honeysuckle, and she planted hundreds of wildflowers, and she moved out of her wicked aunt's house, and she finally got her freedom.
Good for her.
Do you know why I told you this?
No.
You were born into a family that doesn't always appreciate you. But one day, things are going to be very different. Should we go inside and have tea and cookies?
Yes, please.
Okay.
This is a cottage from your story.
Yes.
The young woman is you. But then... No.
Yes. And Trunchbull.
House.
Tea time.
Of course, Matilda was a frequent visitor.
Did you know that the heart of a mouse beats at the rate of 650 times a minute?
Hi. Where'd you learn that?
In a book. It beats so fast it doesn't sound like it's beating at all. It sounds like it's humming. Porcupine's heart beats 300 times a minute. All right.
Wait!
Hey, you! Hey, we're leaving. Come on, let's go. Get in the car. Hurry up. Let's wrap up these cookies. Come on, we're leaving. Now.
I'd be happy to walk her home.
Well, nobody will be there. We're moving to Guam. Come on.
Let's go. Guam?
Yeah. Daddy's not going to be in the auto business anymore.
I don't want to leave. We're going on a permanent vacation.
Yeah, and we got to beat the speedboat salesman to the airport.
I love it here. I love my school. It isn't fair.
Miss Honey, please don't let them
get in the car, Melinda.
Matilda.
Whatever.
I wanted to stay with Miss Honey.
Well, Miss Honey doesn't want you. Why would she want some snotty, disobedient kid?
Because she's a spectacularly wonderful child, and I love her.
Adopt me, Miss Honey. You can adopt me.
Look, I don't have time for all these legalities.
1 second, Dad. I have the adoption papers.
What? Hey, where'd you get those?
From a book in the library. I've had them since I was big enough to Xerox.
Are you hearing this, Harry?
All you have to do is sign them.
I'll be an only child again.
Shut up! I can't think with all these sirens. What do you think, Pumpkin?
You're the only daughter I ever had, Matilda. And I never understood you, not one little bit. Who's got a pen?
Here.
Thanks.
And doing perhaps the first decent thing they ever did for their daughter, the Wormwoods signed the adoption papers.
Okay. Here. Okay.
All right, come on. Turn around. You're not going to be calling us for support payments or something like that, huh?
Oh, no. We'll have everything we need. Don't worry.
All right, here. Let's roll.
Ciao.
So Harry and Zinnia got away. And as bad as things were before, that's how good they became. Miss Honey was made principal of Crunchham Hall, which had to add an upper school because children never wanted to leave. And Matilda found, to her great surprise, that life would be fun. And she decided to have as much of it as possible. After all, she was a very smart kid.
Well, I would like to hold my little hand. How about we run with? How about cry?
But the happiest part of the story is that Matilda and Miss Honey each got what they had always wanted, a loving family. And Matilda never had to use her powers again. Well, I mean almost never.
Precisely, having little